Bancroft brings us back into the wacky post-apocalyptic wasteland, this time in the city of Boston, otherwise known as the Commonwealth. Bethesda somehow managed to capture the same magic of exiting the vault and bringing you into a vast, open, and expansive world. The Commonwealth ranges from large cityscapes of central Boston to disheartening, swampy areas. After events transpire, you awaken 200 years after the bombs initially fell. Here, the story begins a very personal quest. Over the course of your journey, you meet many different factions with different views that help you to achieve your cause. The pacing starts out a bit slow, but then picks up and the story really starts coming along. I was very satisfied with it up until the ending. The issue was, they tried to force themes of morality and loss, which in turn have quite a few plot holes and didn't wrap up the story the way it should have. And I also say ways with an S because there were multiple different endings, though they are not remarkably different from each other. Solid level design was prevalent through all of it. The only other complaints I had, besides for the ending, where the quest sometimes got a bit repetitive, and the limitations in the dialogue mode made me feel like I had less choice in this than the previous games. Overall, the story was very good, but not amazing. As I said earlier, there's a definite limitation in the dialogue. Bethesda decided to go with a more Mass Effect approach. By Mass Effect approach, I mean there are really only 4 choices in each conversation. This causes less options, but all dialogue from the main character is in fact voice. It is nice to actually see the emotions of your character play out, but that doesn't mean the system is necessarily good. Most dialogue conversations boil down to yes, no, sarcastic, or ask a question about what you were just told. It felt a bit simplistic. I found myself always going with a sarcastic option when I wanted to say yes because it was almost always hilarious and condescending.
Are you here for the synth?
I'm here to pick up an order. 2 large pepperoni and a calzone. Name is Fuck You.
The dialogue did not leave nearly as many choices as Fallout 3, New Vegas, or even Skyrim, which really bothered me. I do have to give them credit for what they did though. 13,000 lines for each character and some damn good voice acting don't make it a huge issue for me personally. The overall combat in the game is very much improved. Guns now pack a nice powerful kick and have great animations. Melee weapons, on the other hand, feel as clunky as ever, and I found myself staying away from them. There are many ways to play the game. Stealth is now an option more than ever, and I felt myself relying on it quite a bit, though the system itself felt very archaic, and there were many times I was not or was seen when I definitely shouldn't have been. Going guns blazing is always encouraged, and chucking grenades is now easier due to the fact of only having to press a single button. BATS, which stands for Vault Tech Assisted Targeting System, slows down time and lets you pinpoint a body part you want to hit, almost like a turn-based RPG. Unlike in the previous Fallouts, you don't have all the time in the world to pick your shots, but you can be hit, and not all your shots are going to land if they're from ridiculously far away. It's a luck-based system. Enemy design in the game received an overhaul as well. Raiders and other human enemies now take cover and hold much smarter angles, rather than all just charging you. Ghouls now act more vicious and can be downright terrifying when overwhelmed. Enemies like the mole rat and scorpion now burrow underground and surprise you with attacks. The enemies all felt very unique and makes you change up your playstyle for each fight. Do you take cover and shoot your way out, or jump on top of a car where you know the ghouls cannot get you? Possibly my favorite part about the new system are the random encounters. Walking around Boston and finding Brotherhood super mutants really adds to the feeling of being in a living, breathing world. The game is noticeably harder than its predecessors. I normally play Bethesda games on a comfortable difficulty where challenge does exist, but it's not entirely frustrating. In most of them, that fell on the hard difficulty or very hard. In this game, it fell on normal. Some enemies can take tons of damage and hit hard. For instance, one enemy I shot a mini nuke at, which killed almost every single enemy in one hit, and all the previous Fallout games, got up and started shooting me again, killing me within seconds. This change makes the game feel far more rewarding when you do accomplish things, and the adding of quicksand on console makes the game overall a lot more forgiving. Many other difficulties await you in the wasteland besides for just the enemies. Radiation exists, and the more you consume, the greater it reduces your maximum health. This can be cured, however, by seeing a doctor or using some Radaway. Your health doesn't automatically regenerate either. Instead, you need to use stim packs, food, or go to sleep to regenerate it. Cooking foods you get from animals is also a very wise decision, as it removes all radiation and increases the amount of health it regenerates significantly. There are also various chemicals in the game that increase certain stats for a short period of time, but can become addictive if taken too much. The leveling system in Fallout 4 is excellent. You gain experience for completing quests, killing enemies, successfully persuading people, lockpicking, and just about anything that involves some skill. Fallout 4's perks have been divided into categories based on your special points: strength, perception, endurance, charisma, intelligence, agility, and luck. You pick what points you want to increase and decrease for your special at the beginning of the game. From there, more or less perks are unlocked for purchase based on the amount of points you put into that particular special. Each time you level, you receive a point, which can be used to either purchase a new perk or put into one of your special abilities to unlock the ability to purchase a particular perk. You kind of see where I'm going with this, it's a bit complicated, but you'll get it once you jump in. It essentially makes the game much more class-based. You can be a silver-tongued devil talking your way through every situation with high charisma or high in agility, able to sneak around and use VATS far more often. It was a fantastic idea for them to show what all perks and their respective ranks do. Because of this, I was able to plan out my build far ahead. For some reason, Fallout 4 decided to go highly customizable. You can now create settlements. Here you take junk parts you find in the world and put together settlements, creating houses, farms, and crazy electric creations. Wastelanders can then move into the area to live. You can benefit from them by having them do various jobs, running around the area, run your supplies from one settlement to another, or set up shop and create profit. The whole system itself is pretty ridiculous and doesn't always work like it should, but it's entertaining and I found myself spending way more time with it than I thought I ever would. Along with settlement building, you can now customize weapons and armor. For weapons, you can select individual pieces to place on a weapon, such as an improved base that may give you more damage, but increases the amount of recoil. I found this change to be excellent, and it gave me hundreds of combinations to work with. The armor system is a bit more simplistic, and only lets you color or improve your armor. There is little customization, besides for the color. Power armor, like in previous Fallout games, is present here, but they did some changing up. Now power armor acts more like a vehicle, where you actually get into it. It is by far the most durable armor in the game, increasing carrying loads and offering substantial radiation resistance. The flip side to it being so powerful is that you need to use fusion cores to keep the armor working, and these are few and far between. I really liked the changes to the power armor, I was just annoyed by how early you got it in the game, and I would have much rather preferred to work for it. Looting has been improved as well. When you want to loot an item or a corpse, a quick little menu will display where you can select what you want to take. This is a big change because in previous installments you had to stop whatever you were doing and a menu would appear that would freeze time, and then you could loot. Due to the building feature in the game, every item is useful now, so it is in best interest to pick up as much as you can carry. Scouring areas for ammo, weapons, specific junk for an item you want to build, and collectibles is still a ton of fun too. There's always something useful to find in every area and behind every locked door. I just wish that some of the bobbleheads weren't placed in such hard-to-see spots. The side quests in the game are either decent or great. Some feel like fetch quests, while some had you doing random and unique things. Faction quests, on the other hand, are dull and repetitive. These involve a lot of doing the same thing for a small reward and became boring very quickly. The best quests you come across are the ones you find making your way through the world. Exploration in Bethesda games has always been the pinnacle in all of gaming, and it's no exception here. The map isn't huge, but it's so dense that you can't go more than a couple feet without finding something to tell your friend about. Within my first couple hours of the game, I found a robot that sounded like a hipster. I also met many interesting characters and made many new friends and enemies. Exploring one side of a train car, I was greeted by a suicide super mutant on the other end. You really cannot beat the feeling of exploration this game provides. Companions are back as well. Each of them start out as very two-dimensional characters at first. The more they open up to you, the more complex you find each one of them to truly be. Doing certain actions that they deem good or bad determine whether they attempt to be more friendly to you or just leave your service. Your actions very much dictate your relationship with each companion, and I think that is a very welcome change. In combat, they, like the enemies, will take cover and play quite smart. I did, however, end up abusing them a little bit and using them as bait. Fallout 4 may seem like a whole lot of sunshine and rainbows, but it has a ludicrous amount of issues. I remarked earlier that the game was beautiful. When I said beautiful, I meant at a distance. Bethesda chose to go with a very bright and colorful art style, where everything looks good when you're not 5 feet within it. Up close, textures look ugly and outdated, and just shining your Pip-Boy light to remove the remarkable volumetric lighting reveals that the game looks almost exactly like Fallout 3. Compared to other games that came out like Witcher and Batman, this game does not hold up to today's standards. For how the game looks, you might expect it to run well, but it doesn't. Frame rate drops on PS4, Xbox One, and PC are all very present, especially in the city area. I have my computer dropping down to lower than 30 frames per second in these areas, and I have a top-line graphics card, so that's quite ridiculous. The loading screens themselves, while cool to look at, last around 30 to 40 seconds. This feels especially unreasonable when you take into account most games nowadays only have to load once when putting you into the world. menu screens are still not very well organized. A sorting option is there, but it doesn't tell you how you sort your gear, so it seems quite pointless. The game also removed many of the RPG mechanics to become more mainstream. There are less options for dialogue, choices to make, and weapon durability doesn't exist anymore besides for in power armor. The karma system has also been removed, and the game wants you to play as the good guy, as there are not many opportunities in the main story to just mess up and ruin people's lives. It's also made worse by companions judging you for every evil action you commit. The most prevalent issue in the game has to be the bugs. I have so much footage of people walking into walls, I can make a feature-length film. I've also had to deal with texture leakage, followers not doing what I told them, keyboard controls that will randomly break, enemies glitching out, sound that just stopped working randomly, NPCs hammering at nothing, farmers plowing the air, and objects that don't work correctly. Check out this scene of this awesome enemy I randomly unlocked from its cage. Somehow, through 40 hours, the game only crashed once, and I only had one quest glitch, which worked again after reloading the game. Some of the bugs are honestly pretty funny, but that's no excuse for how often this game breaks. Fallout 4 is a great RPG despite all its flaws. There is an argument to be made of a game with so much great content overcoming many of the things that hold it back from success. I believe Fallout 4 is that argument. It has excellent gameplay, a good story, great characters, and top-of-the-line exploration. If the bugs bother you, I'd wait a month or two, but if you think you can see past the wrinkles, the Boston Wasteland is a wonderful place to step into. Keep a knocking, but you can't.